गुड मॉर्निंग टू एवरीवन। टुडे इज योर क्लास फॉर द स्विच गियर एंड प्रोटेक्शन। दिस इज द लेक्चर नंबर 11th फॉर द सब्जेक्ट स्विच गियर एंड प्रोटेक्शन। सो इन टुडेज टॉपिक वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस रिगार्डिंग द प्रोटेक्शन ऑफ अल्टरनेटर्स। सो बिफोर नोइंग हाउ टू प्रोटेक्ट द अल्टरनेटर फ्रॉम द फॉल्ट्स, we must have the knowledge of what are the various type of faults that may occur on the alternators. So as alternators are few in numbers and higher in their initial cost as compared to the other equipments, so this element alternator becomes our first priority. To save this element from the faults, we have to gather knowledge regarding what are the different varieties or types of faults that may occur on an alternator. And the second thing is, what are the various protection schemes can be used against the protection of faults for the alternators. As the generators are of two types, the first is DC generator and the second is AC generator. So AC generators are generally called as alternators. ठीक है, बिकॉज ऑफ द हाई इनिशियल कॉस्ट ऑफ द अल्टरनेटर्स, इट इज आवर प्राइम ड्यूटी टू प्रोटेक्ट इट अगेंस्ट द वेरियस टाइप्स ऑफ फॉल्ट्स। सो दीज आर सम ऑफ द फॉल्ट्स विच मे ऑकर ऑन द पावर सिस्टम। दीज आर सम ऑफ द इम्पोर्टेंट फॉल्ट्स विच मे ऑकर ऑन द पावर सिस्टम एंड आर नेम्ड एज failure of prime mover, failure of field, overcurrent, overspeed, overvoltage, unbalanced loading and stator winding faults. So these are the few types which we are going to discuss in the today's class. So the first category of fault is the failure of prime mover. So this category of fault generally implies that if input to the prime mover of an alternator, or we can say that if input to the turbine of an alternator stopped, or the input to the prime alternator is very less, okay, in that particular case our turbine starts running in the inverse direction. Okay, so that running of turbine in the inverse direction due to the failure of the input, or the quantity of input is very less, that inverse running is known as inverted running of the alternator. So during the inverted running of the alternator, it behaves as an synchronous motor. So when it behaves as an synchronous motor during inverted running, it starts drawing the electricity from the load. In order to overcome this fault, the attendant in the control room, after knowing the type of fault inverted running has happened, it may manually stop the alternator from supply current. So this type of fault, automatic protection is not necessary. From manual controls we can control this category of fault. So automatic protection is not necessary to this fault. The second category of fault is the failure of field. So the chances of failure of field is very rare in the case of alternators. The first thing is, the chance is very rare. If it may occur, the field windings get failed, the alternator can be run without the field. So for a short period of time, alternator may run without a field. So the attendant in the control room may manually disconnect the alternator from the system bus bars, and it is not universal practice to provide protection against this particular type of contingency. So the operator in the control room can handle this category of fault. The third category is overcurrent fault. The overcurrent fault is mainly due to the, if there is a sudden fall of the load. if there is a sudden fall of the load, overcurrent may occur inside the alternator. So in order to overcome this category of faults, overcurrent relays are typically used. So by using the overcurrent relays, we can reduce the effects of overcurrents in an alternator. So similarly, over speed, we can say that overcurrent may happen due to this, or it may happen due to the failure of the windings insulations. Due to that, overcurrent may happen. Overspeed mostly occurs due to the sudden fall of the load. Overspeed occurs. So when we talk regarding the overvoltage, so overvoltage occurs due to the insulation failure. Okay. Or it can occur due to the sudden, if we suddenly cut off the load. Okay. In case of steam turbines, we use governors. So governors, what governors can do in case of steam turbines, governors can easily control the main valve, which is the input to the turbine, so that the speed of the turbine gets controlled. Or we can use the over voltage relays for this particular purpose. Okay. So the sixth category of fault is unbalanced loading. So in the unbalanced loading, if a fault occurs between phase to ground or between phase to phase due to the unsymmetrical fault, there is a unequal current flowing across all the three phases. So when unequal current starts flowing, the system may fall into a asynchronism. So in order to system becomes unbalanced, we can say that the protection against the unbalanced loading is provided. In the end, there is a stator winding fault. The most severe nature of fault is the stator winding fault. It is the most dangerous fault on the alternator. It can provide maximum damage to the alternator if protection against this particular category of fault is not provided, stator winding fault. So for the protection of the stator winding fault, Mears-Prize system is basically used. So by using the Mears-Prize system, we can generally provide the protection against the fault. This is a category of differential relay. This is an advanced version of differential relay scheme. So we use differential relays because of its property of distinguishing the fault between the minor load conditions and the major load conditions. We may generally use differential relay scheme named as Mears-Prize system schemes. So there is a one diagram showing how protection can be provided against the fault. So here are the three phases of the alternators. Current transformers are connected across all the three phases. So whenever there is a normal current flowing, there is no fault conditions. The current across both the ends are equal. So there is no net current flowing across the relay operating coil. So the trip circuit remains open. Whenever there is a sudden fault, the values of the current at both the ends may get changed, and the difference of the current gets start flowing through this relay operating coil. When current flows across the relay operating coil, the trip circuit closes its contacts, which in turn opens the contacts of the circuit breaker and removes the alternator from the faulty section. In this way, alternator can be protected against the unbalanced loading fault, due to which the currents in all the three phases get changed. So this is the protection scheme employed. This is not the differential scheme. This is a half version of differential scheme. In the next lecture, we will discuss in detail the full Mears-Prize protection scheme. Thank you, guys.